What is up, man? I said, you know what? I'm not gonna make the same mistake I made the other day, man. Yeah, man. What's up, guys? What's happening, man? Salute to everybody, man. To everybody watching over on Rumble, man. Rumble gang up in this bitch. Salute to Rumble gang, man. Yeah, I was like, man, I tried to lay down and take a nap, and I was like, you know what, this isn't necessarily going the way I want it. I was like, man, get your big ass up and just go live, man. Just go live, man. Just go live, man. I was like, man, just go live, fuck it. Because I was trying to get some sleep. I was trying to get some sleep. Now we're gonna get into that, Cornelius, man. We're gonna get into all that, man. I'm sure you're shocked too. I know Cornelius is shocked by the way this played out. I know you're shocked, man. Make sure you let's all give Cornelius a little bit of time to get himself up off the floor, because I know he fell out of his chair when he saw the way this story played out. And all of the rest of you guys that I know, I know you guys are stunned by how this turned out. And you guys are floored. Just try to, you know, get yourself. I'm gonna give you guys a little time to get yourself together, man, before we start, man. I don't know, maybe you get an ice pack or something, because I know some of you guys bumped your head after you fainted when you saw how this thing turned out. I know a lot of you guys fainted. But go on, get up, get yourself together, and we'll start the show when you guys get your wits about you. You know what I mean? I'm fair, man. You said, is there a merch raffle soon? Oh, man. A merch raffle. So, like, you know what? That's a good idea, man. I haven't even thought about that. Like, raffle off a shirt. How would I do that, man? Like, how would I digital raffle tickets? How do you do that, man? You got to tell me. You got to give me some, point me in the right direction. How would you do that? You say, I threw you off. When did I throw you off, Nate Ways? Nah, I was trying to take a nap. Then I was like, it wasn't going well, man. See, usually I listen to History Debunked. That usually to go to sleep, because his voice puts me to sleep. And you know what I need? Builder. That's what I need. I need to get Builder. Builder to, like, I need to let Builder go on a tangent for like 5-10 minutes and then record it and then I can watch that, and that'll put me to sleep. Because something about old British dudes, man, they make me sleepy, man. Merch raffle for random lucky Aknu subscribers. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, I don't know how. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I got you. That, you know what? I could do that a lot easier if everyone creates an account on the Op Nation merch store. Because if you create an account on the Op Nation merch store, I can just go in to your account and put a fucking discount code like for 100% off. And then you could just buy the stuff and you could get whatever you want on there and send it to yourself. Because I'm not with a whole lot of moving parts. I'm not like gonna go to the post office with no box. My shit is like, I don't touch any of the products. All my products go straight through Printful and Shopify. I don't touch a product. I'm not sitting here boxing up shit and sending it to y'all when y'all order something from the merch store. My products come straight. I design all the products. I make all the clothes. I design all the hats. I design all the mugs. I make all the prices. And then when you order it, it comes straight from the warehouse. I never touch the product. I think they call it, was it drop shipping or something shit like that? Yeah, you know what? I'll do that. Next week, I'm a raffle off, but I'm only going to do it for people who have created accounts on the Op Nation merch store. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a raffle. We're going to do a raffle next week. I'm going to be giving away some free merchandise. But it's only for people who have created accounts. You don't have to buy anything, but it's only going to be for people who created accounts on the Op Nation merch store. Because if you haven't created an account, it's really hard for me to get you shit because I don't touch the products. So if you want to be part of next week's raffle, free stuff I'm going to be raffling off next week, mugs, hoodies, stuff like that, shirts. Make sure you create an account at the Op Nation merch store. The link is in the description box. All you got to do is sign up, create an account. You don't have to buy anything if you don't want. I'll give away a couple shirts. We'll find out. Yeah, salute Martin B, man. Yeah, man. I definitely, yeah, app, man, that wouldn't be bad, man. I'm gonna have to look into that. Make sure you sign up on Rumble, man. I'm over on Rumble, man. So make sure you guys get an account. Also, sign up for my Rumble channel, man, because I simulstream. In fact, you know what? Let me find that video that I wanted to do, man. It's a video I wanted to do today. Let me see something here. Woo! My sunshine. Let's see. Yeah, let's see how this is going. Let's see. It's one video I want to show. Oh, yeah, here it is. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we may be going over to Rumble after 12, man. Yeah, I'm gonna vote on it, man. I'm gonna put a poll up, man. I'm gonna let y'all decide, man, because if it's some stuff that if y'all wanna go over to Rumble, let me put a poll up after Yeah, man, it's a lot going on, man. I mean, it's, listen, man. Yeah, all you guys, make sure you sign up for Rumble, because if you don't have an account on Rumble either, you won't be able to comment. For some reason, Rumble doesn't let you comment unless you create an account. So make sure you take a few seconds. Take a few seconds. Make sure you take a few seconds to start to get an account over there on Rumble, so that when we do switch over there, because it looks like the poll is gonna it looks like the poll is gonna go Rumble, man. Salute Saverick, she says, do you understand most of my dense super chats? Yeah, I mean, you're very deep, man. Very, very deep. Almost, I can't explain it, almost like stoic in a way like that, man. But yeah, I get them. A lot of times I can't, like, you know, go too deep into that stuff because, you know, the show may be going in a certain direction, but keep them coming, man. Yeah, I definitely understand what you're saying, man. I definitely understand. So you just dropped a comment on the Rumble feed? Let's see. I don't see any comments over on Rumble. No, man, we got 8 watching over on Rumble. Salute the Rumble, man. Yeah, man. Boston been blasting a bit lately. Wow. So are you ready to rumble? This message is for YouTube. Peace out in the chat. Yeah, man. We're going to rumble after 12 at midnight, man. So we gotta get all this stuff going, man. All this Memphis effery out the way, man. Let me get some of this Memphis effery out the way. Poor lady, man. Poor woman, man. She got sunburnt, man. She got sunburnt, man. She got sun-kissed. She got sun-kissed, man. Kissed by the sun, man. And I'm going to catch everybody up who's not up to date on this story. I'm going to catch all you guys up. You said the Android app doesn't have a rolling chat, only the regular comment section. Yeah, there's no chat on Rumble. It's just the comment section. Oh, no, not the comment section. It's the rolling chat, but it's not like the one on YouTube. The Rumble chat is just, you know, you can do super chat and everything on Rumble, but the comment section where the comments are just for the video, that's all they have on the app. Okay. So you got to watch it. If you want to participate in the live chat on Rumble, you have to do it on a PC or laptop. I have to do it on a laptop or a PC. Yeah, Jared, they must have, I don't know what happened to your comment over there on Rumble. I haven't seen it. 2 gliders killed 10 and stabbed 30 in Saskatchewan. Damn, at large still. Yo, I saw that, man. I saw a piece of that before I tried to lay down and take my nap. Saskatch. Okay. Chewan. All right. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Mass stabbing. Manhunt underway. They're looking for 2 guys. They look like hombritos, man. These 2 guys look like hombritos, man. Let me see. Let me show y'all. Yeah, that's some old shit. But look, didn't they just ban guns? Didn't they just ban guns in Canada? This is great for the 2A people. This is great for the 2A people. I mean, come on. They just banned guns, man. And what's his name? What's that guy's name? That real handsome prime minister they got. What's his name? Trudeau. He just banned guns, man. Or seriously revoked their gun rights. And it goes to show you, man. It goes to show you, man. Yeah, salute to Jared, man. Yeah, man, listen to Jared, man. Jared know what he's talking about, man. What happened to Jared, man? Where's Jared at, man? Jared was my boy, man. Jared, the white guy used to come up on here, man. I ain't seen him in a while, man. The glider, man. Glider, Jared from Subway. Where's anybody seen Jared from Subway, man? What happened to Jared from Subway, man? I know Jimmy probably having back surgery. I think Jimmy said he's having back surgery again. Greedy says, I'm not going to lie. I thought it would be a glider that kidnapped her. But you're right again. She jogged out in the sun and is probably dead for it. Listen, man. We were hoping it was a glider. Let's put it like that, man. We were all hoping that it was a glider, man. Because, you know, the whole previous week, there was a firestorm because a white guy allegedly shouted the N-word at a black woman. So there's no way the next week a sun man could kidnap a fucking heiress to a billion-dollar company and kill her and not a peep. You have to understand that. Not a peep. No one wants to touch this story about this heiress, man, being kidnapped. And what's by a sun man. But last week, oh man, BYU students are racist. Some guy who went to another school but was at the game yelled the N-word at the black player the whole game. And you tell me that's not privilege? My God, that's privilege, man. Let me touch on this. Saskatchewan thing right quick, man. I don't know too much about this Saskatchewan thing. Let me touch on this thing right quick. Let me see.
So we have 10 confirmed deceased individuals. We have 13 active crime scenes that we are investigating. So at some of those crime scenes, there may not have been a deceased individual. There could have been injured individuals who were not deceased. The priority right now is to locate them and
what are these guys, man? Are these Prairie Patels? They look like they may have I don't know. What do they consider these in Canada? Are these Britos or Prairie Patels? He said, "Oh, she's beautiful." Yeah, she's gorgeous, man. I ain't gonna lie, man. That police captain, man, she's stunning and brave, man. You said these guys look Turkish. I'm not getting Middle Eastern vibes, but it may be, man. I wouldn't be surprised. They're not gliders, man. You gliders are off the hook, man. Gliders is off the hook, man. This use these. Damn, man. You say maybe Syrian? I don't know, man. I'm not getting Middle Eastern vibes from these guys. I'm getting more like maybe. I'm getting more like Prairie Patel or Amrita. We'll see.
The priority right now is to locate them and make sure that we have them in custody so that we can ensure the public of their safety. At this point in time, we have no indication that they've traveled to another province. But given the fact that they are in a vehicle, we can't say with 100% certainty where they are right now. And we believe it's prudent to notify the residents of those provinces that there is a possibility they could have traveled to those locations and making them aware of.
This is why I always keep a blade on me, man. Because you can't, if I carry a gun, you know, in DC, man, you know, I don't have a license, a permit, anything like that. But I always carry a blade. I mean, I carry a blade to church, man. Because if somebody got a fucking knife, man, and you pull out one, they're most likely going to, if they're on some mission like this, they're going to try somebody else, man. It's not worth it, man. If you pull out, if they come up with a knife and they stabbing a bunch of people and you pull out one, they're probably just going to go mess with somebody else, man.
This current situation that we're dealing with. We know that the initial calls were for victims of stabbings. The rest of the investigative pieces that are being put into place right now will confirm if there were any additional injuries, but that's the information we have at this point in time. We don't have that information. It appears that some of the victims may have been targeted and some may be random. So to speak to a motive would be extremely difficult at this point in time. Our investigation will certainly focus on that aspect of it as well.
Yeah, man. It's crazy out here, man.
Welcome back to the show. First, to that breaking news at 9, a huge story unfolding overseas. Canadian police have confirmed at least 10 people have been killed in a stabbing spree in Saskatchewan. A lot to our U.S. correspondent, Amelia Adams. Amelia, what do we know so far?
Yeah, I got some rough women up there in Canada, man. Some rough looking glider queens up there in Canada, man. Man, born in the USA. I was born in the USA. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. Shit. Sweet home Alabama. Shit, y'all got some rough looking women up there in Canada, man.
Well, Carl, we know that as well as those 10 people who were stabbed to death, more than a dozen have been hospitalized with injuries. The victims were found dead or injured in 13 different locations across two different communities in that Saskatchewan province of Canada. Police have just provided an update.
Several additional victims have been injured, 15 of which at this point have been transported to various hospitals. There may be additional injured victims who transported themselves to various hospitals.
Now, the suspects are still at large. Authorities have identified them as Damien and Miles Sanderson. They're 30 and 30.
Damien and Miles Sanderson. Those are Prairie Patels, man. I think these are Prairie Patels, man. I don't know. Anything. Damien and Miles, usually if they were on Britos, they would have one of their names at least would be Spanish, if not the first name or the last name. But you rarely find an Ombrito where one of the names is not Spanish. So these look like Prairie Patels, man, or Inuits. I think they're called Inuits up there. But
Now, the suspects are still at large. Authorities have identified them as Damien and Miles Sanderson. They're 30 and 31, so we have to assume they're brothers. They are on the run. There is a massive manhunt underway for them over three provinces. Police checkpoints everywhere, helicopters, people are being told to stay indoors. Police say that some of the victims do appear to have been targeted, but that others were randomly attacked. So just repeating that breaking news, 10 dead, stabbed to death, 15 hospitalised, the victims found across 13 locations. So multiple victims, multiple locations, as we wait for more details, Carl, on this developing story out of Canada.
Amelia, thank you.
Yeah, man, that's crazy, man. Wow. Wow. I don't want to see that lady face again. That lady ugly as shit. I'm gonna see. Let me see if I can watch another video. Hopefully she's not in it. Yeah, so they no more news on that so far. Let's see what else is. Holy shit, the mass shooting in Norfolk. Overnight, man. Norfolk gun violence, man. What do you know? HBCU had a, it was a mass shooting at a HBCU, and we didn't hear a peep about it, man. I mean, not a peep. Let's see what's going on, man. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to let me drop the link, man. We're gonna have to do a Labor Day weekend body count, man. We're gonna have to do a Labor Day weekend war report, man. Cause it's looking real, real crazy. Ouch. Yeah. All right. So the link is in. Let me put the link. The link is in the, about to be in the description box. Let me see. Yeah, those guys, those Prairie Patels do have some glider blood though. So I can't let gliders off the hook completely, man. What's happening, man?
What's up, sir? How's it going?
Everything's cool, man. What's new, man? Did you? I'm sure you're inundated with, you know, news stories about this mass shooting at the HBCU campus, right?
Man, I didn't hear nothing about it either, man. I'm not shocked though.
Oh wow, man! wow, man! I'm surprised, man. Because I mean, it's been all over CNN and MSNBC.
I'm half retarded, man. I get my news from here.
Oh, okay, yeah, man. This is the underground, man. Let's see what's happening, man.
Just get it.
At 11 o'clock or almost midnight. In the 5,000 block of Kilham Avenue, we had an event where seven individuals were shot at a party. Two of those ended up being a homicide. As with most of our homicides, this is the result of conflict between people, we think. So this is not randomly picked. These are, and this is what is frustrating about these things right now. People get into a disagreement, they pull out a gun, and then they shoot each other. And in the process,
I try to tell people, and you know this too, Nate Ways, they just don't care who they hit. You know?
No, they really don't. It's just pull out the gun and shoot. Whoever hits, fuck it.
Yeah. They see, I think they may see everybody who's at the party as like, look, man, you're at this party with these type of motherfuckers. Fuck you too. Or you know what I'm saying? Like, they don't value the lives of the people that share public spaces with them.
Yeah, that's like my only beef with the violence, the senseless violence, because I don't care if adults want to shoot each other. I really don't. But when innocent people get hit, you know, that's fucked up.
Yeah, it's very fucked up. It is, man. It's because, I mean, these it's probably some townies, you know, people from Norfolk at a party with some Norfolk State students. And, you know, just spray the fucking crowd, man, and hit a bunch of students too, man. It's just
crazy.
People get into a disagreement, they pull out a gun, and then they shoot each other. And in the process of doing that, they shoot innocent people who end up dying. That cannot be tolerated. And we are going to get after that. We are working very hard, and our investigators are working very hard, but this is a conflict resolution issue. This is an issue with a society who's decided to go to violence to solve their things instead of using other means. We will not tolerate that.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Follow today.
Okay, so he says it's all of society in 8 ways. What do you think about that? It's the entire society.
Yeah, yeah. We. That's funny. That's real funny.
We're starting with breaking news this morning. After a busy night in Norfolk, police there are investigating on Killam Avenue and 18th Bay Street. Now, we are told one of the investigations is a mass shooting investigation. The first incident happened early this morning on 18th Bay Street and Pleasant Avenue. This is in the Ocean View area. Here is video of the scene before police wrapped up. We are working to learn more information from the Norfolk Police spokesperson about what happened and if anyone was hurt. Then around midnight, Norfolk Police responded to a mass shooting near Old Dominion University. There, we know 7 people are hurt following the shooting. This is considered a mass shooting. 10 on your side's Brett Hall has been there all morning long gathering details. Brett, what have you learned?
We know this was a very chaotic scene that unfolded here just blocks from Old Dominion University in the early morning hours. And police are still out here on the scene nearly now 8 hours after they were first called to these homes that are being used mostly as rental housing. We know there's a lot of students in this area. Not sure who was in this home, but we know that 7 people at least were shot just after 12, 2 of them taken to the hospital with serious injuries. We've counted almost 30 evidence markers that forensics has put down here in the last 2 hours since we have been here. And we're learning that some of the victims are students of Norfolk State University. The university putting out a statement on Twitter this morning saying that they're going to have counselors available at school. We do not know how many victims were involved at this point. Some other things we do not know at this hour is if they arrested anybody for what happened here last night, how many shooters there may have been. But we know that this really put a strain on the already tight resources of Norfolk Public Safety. Norfolk Sentara Hospital, Norfolk General, was in lockdown temporarily because, again, this was not the only shooting that Norfolk Police had to respond to.
So remember, it's the entire community down there in Norfolk that's the problem. What's up, Mama Alien? What's going on, man? Who are you?
Hey, thanks for having me.
What's up, man? Where are you from?
I'm a UK glider.
Okay, man.
UK glider. All right.
Yeah, man. What's new, man?
Well, me being on here for a start. Long time fan. First time visitor.
Okay, great. Now, they saying the police chief down there, or the police, whoever that was, the captain, is saying that this gun violence, you know, down here in Norfolk, Virginia, is, you know, just, it's the entire community. Everyone needs to change their ways. All the groups, the gliders, the Patels, the Hombritos, the Crouching Tigers, everyone is complicit with this gun violence. Is that the same thing you're seeing over there in the UK?
Yeah, absolutely. It's the narrative, because anything else would just be racist, wouldn't it?
Yeah. So yeah, it's very interesting that they say everyone. It's just there's vague terms. I'm gonna go to the Norfolk Gun Memorial. We're gonna see if that's true.
Last night, And we also know that there weren't even some medics available for more minor calls last night because of everything going on out here. So a very active investigation ongoing. I'm sure we're going to learn more throughout the day. Make sure you stay with us. We'll have another update online and, of course, on Wavy News 10 at 6 tonight.
So there was so much shooting in Norfolk last night. They had to lock down the hospital. And
at 11 o'clock,
there weren't enough fucking, like, cops to fucking patrol the city. I mean, I just don't know how you... Well, it's everybody. So let's see. Let me see what's going on here. It's everybody. All right. So let me share my screen so I can see. So we just want to, you know, I believe the chief. Chief, if you're watching, man, I'm not trying to, you know, say your line. I just want to check it. Like Colin said, man, you know, if your mom tells you she loves you, check it out. You know, so let's see. Okay.
You know, Ock, if they keep on pushing this narrative, though, man, you know, it takes away the personal accountability.
Yeah. Wow. So let's see. Everybody. This isn't looking like everybody, man. This is looking like one particular group, man, out here in Norfolk, Virginia, man. That's involved with this gun violence, man.
I think I might see one glider, a ginger at that, the beard there.
Yeah. This one?
And then there's that little dude there. I see two. Two
gliders. Yeah, but they were probably killed by... This one right here, man, he was most likely killed by a sun man, man. He was... Who do you think killed him, man?
Oh, that was definitely a sun man that got him. That he looks like a dominant glider.
Yeah, man. Yeah, he looked like he went the way of the sun, man. This one right here, a sailor found aboard a carrier died from... Oh, this is he's committed suicide. Okay. Yeah, man, it seems like... I don't know, man. It's looking like... It's looking like it's just one group, man. Yeah, it's looking like it's just one group, man. This is a murder suicide. She got killed in a murder suicide.
Cute Puerto Rican.
Yeah. Yeah, this glider. Yeah, listen, man. Chief, if you're watching, man, Norfolk City Chief, I think you need to amend that statement you made about it being everybody. It looked like it's one group, man, that's doing all the gun violence, man, in your place, man. It's funny that you don't know that, and you're the chief, man. That's kind of odd.
I don't see no suits and ties up there either, you know.
Nah, it's just one group of sun men.
See, here's the thing, Ak. You go to the gun memorial regularly all over the state, and it's a consistent point that you keep making. But how come you're the only person speaking the truth on the internet? And every news report basically says you must be crazy or lying. How is it still going on?
I don't understand how no one else goes to the gun memorial. That's odd to me, like... Because it's other channels that's kind of like in my lane a little bit, you know what I mean? Like, they're not really, they don't, of course they don't, you know what I'm saying? But that's like, you know, I guess if you would call us a genre, there's other channels in this genre, and they don't, none of them go to the gun memorial.
I never even knew about the gun memorial until you, Ock. You're like a hero of mine.
Yeah, man. Thank you, man.
I'm the hero, man.
What's up, Stunner?
What's good, Ock Nation? What up, Chief Akintunde?
Ain't nothing, man. I'm hearing that it's down here in Norfolk, the chief said that it's everybody.
He can't tell the truth, bro. You know that. And to answer our British, sound like he British, our friend from across the pond,
mm-hmm.
The reason why you don't hear more about this is because as soon as you get big enough, you cancel.
Yep.
They throttling the fuck out of my channel, man. I ain't gonna lie, man. They
throttling. If I am mistaken, Google just banned Truth Social.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir.
That's crazy, man. That was like a Twitter for like conservatives or something like that.
It's for everybody, you know what I'm saying? But of course, everybody who was kicked off Twitter, you know, who tended to be on the right hand side, gravitated over there. But it was for everybody, you know what I mean? They still got leftist trolls over there and stuff too. But they banned it because it was gaining traction. It was becoming mainstream.
Jeff Bezos owns the Amazon servers, man, and that's what Google runs off of. So, you know, they're all in cahoots with each other. So until people get their own servers to run shit, ain't nobody making no noise.
Wow, that's crazy.
I just learned Susan Wojcicki, who's the CEO of YouTube, her sister was the chick who originally helped out with the funding to start Google. Helping them out, and they're all very closely connected in one way or another.
Oh yeah,
it's too sinister.
Yeah, I mean, it might not even be sinister. It might just be a good old boys network. Like, you can't invite. Like, think about it, man. They can't just bring anybody into that circle. Those people have secrets and all types of stuff. Like, I mean. They probably have all. When you get rich like that, you've done a lot of shady things, and they just not going to invite anybody into that. So I wouldn't.
You'd be shocked how many people who work in the media have husbands and wives and boyfriends and girlfriends who work in the government.
Exactly, and you have to be codified. I think that's what they call it. Not the word codified, but power is usually
consolidated.
Yeah, consolidated. You need to consolidate power, and that's done all. You know, you're not going to have everybody involved with that, and that's how they stay powerful, by keeping you out of it and keeping only their people that you know in it. But yeah, I mean, all these are things of like, if you studied 48 Laws of Power, you won't get upset by these things, because you'll say, "Oh, touche, touche," because when you observe certain laws and you always increase your power. When you transgress the law, you almost always lose power. So just make sure you check out that 48 Laws of Power, and you won't be upset by it. You won't be offended. You just look at it as kind of like unemotional, and it help you even more with your power game, because when you're not emotional and tied up into the moves you see people make, it helps you look at the board more clearer instead of being clouded by emotions and things like that. And so touche, man. I guess that was a good move by Zuckerberg and them. If they see a competitor coming up on them and they could erase them, they got rid of them. So the next competitor to Twitter is going to have to get their own servers, man, like you said.
Yeah. Also, I'll be honest, I'm a pretty plugged in type kind of character. And I had no idea the gun memorial existed before I started watching this channel.
Yeah, man. It's something that when I found out about it, man, I was like, wow. Because it's one thing to see the names, you know what I mean? It's another thing to see the face. Yo, Savage, man, what's up, man? You coming on the show?
Yo, man? How's it going, brother? Can y'all hear me?
No, do we hear you, man? You
we hear you too well.
Hot, man. Yeah, your mic is fucking hot, bro.
You came in blowing in our ears.
Man. Yeah, exactly. It sounds like, you know, when it's windy and you were trying to record a video outside, that's how it fucks up. Like, you just, But anyway, man, get your shit together, man. Let me mute you, man. You get your shit together. You over there. I don't know what the fuck up with you, man. But yeah, so everybody's,
when you see the faces of these people, and how young most of them are, it really hits home versus when they just tell you someone's been shot on the south side of town.
Like, look at this girl right here.
Yeah.
This girl, she's a Virginia pilot reporter and a former CNN news assistant.
Wokety woke woke.
She don't look like a gangbanger.
Nah, she wasn't a gangbanger.
25 years old, man.
25 years old. She was among two killed in a shooting. Let's just see what happened to her. This is the only one I'm gonna do, and then I'm gonna move along. But we're talking about a fucking former CNN news assistant. So we're talking about somebody who, forget woke, but somebody who was like,
she was 25 and getting it, man.
Yeah, she was in her career, whether she worked at CNN or Fox or whatever. I mean, they're all fucking woke, but it's just crazy. So let's see what happened to her. How did she end up getting shot to death?
Approximation to a summon
or something like this to happen. Like, there's no bigger shock than that.
Maurice Jenkins came to visit the spot where his daughter was shot and killed. His hospital visitor's badge still on his shirt.
I'm assuming it happened right here. And I just wanted to come here because something just made me feel like I just, needed to just come and be where she was last at.
His daughter, 25-year-old Sierra Jenkins, just had a birthday. She was a journalist with a Virginian pilot and a Georgia State graduate.
I can just hear her voice in my head when I answer the phone. Hey, Dad. It's just always, she was a daddy's girl.
Her life cut short. An eyewitness told News 3 that gunfire erupted outside of Chico's on Granby Street around 2 a.m. Saturday. Police say several people were shot.
All kinds of life and opportunity.
Gunfire erupted. So that's a context clues. Like, if it was a white guy, it would have been like, a racist white guy hears his face, shot this black woman out of racial motives, and we don't have any proof, but we know it was racial, and he's a bad person, and this is what's going on in America, and we need to stop this, and we all need to come together, we need to have a national conversation. A black guy do it, gunfire erupted.
2 a.m. as well, context clue.
Yep.
I've cut short, and eyewitness told News 3 that gunfire erupted outside of Chico's on Granby Street around 2 a.m. Saturday. Police say several people were shot.
All kinds of life and opportunity ahead of her, but it was cut short because of senseless violence.
Damn, man. That's fucked up. I feel bad for that guy, man. His fucking daughter, man.
She grew up to be pretty much who you'd want your kid to be.
Yeah, man. She was on the right path, man. Whatever she was doing, whether it was woke or not woke, whatever, she don't fucking know. She's a black woman. All she knows is woke.
Where the wokeness comes in, Ark, is when you woke, you also don't pick up context clues and you don't recognize danger flags. You just float through it, thinking you're gonna be all right. Or just not even recognizing how much danger you're in.
Exactly.
Well, I mean, if you come up in a certain class, period, you're going to be kind of clueless, period. If you're not from violent areas, that shit's just something that happens on the news to most people, man.
Yeah.
I think if she was white, you could say that, but I don't think you could say that like her.
Yeah, she knows. Like, if she a sister, she like he knows. They all listen. Let me show y'all something, man. I just got this other email. Let me pull this up for y'all, man. Somebody just sent this. Salute to TJ, man, for sending this to me, man. This just gives you let me see. This just gives you a window into what's really going on. Okay, so here goes the firearm-related homicides by race, okay? Can you see that? Can you see the table? Right here? Is it? Am I sharing the screen?
We see it now.
Okay. So blue right here is black, non-Hispanic. So it's not like that damn David Ortiz and shit and whatever like that. Just regular black folk. You know what I'm saying? So this is per 100,000. And the light blue right here is Hispanics, and the light blue is gliders. So this is and this is Asian. So Asians, gliders, Hispanics, Prairie Patels, otherwise known as Native Americans, and blacks. Per 100,000, how many of them are going to be killed by gun violence? It's not even close.
But you know, I talk about this stuff with my friends all the time, man, and they don't believe me. They're like, oh, white people kill each other too. I'm like, yeah, but not like this, bro. Like, no, come on.
Not even close. It's not even, this is per 100,000. You can't like, this is beyond reproach. So it's like, you know, like you can just extrapolate this on out to, you know what I mean?
You have direct. To show them this. You can't just, when you're in those conversations, you have to show them this chart, man. They have to see it.
Yeah, and also you got to be careful too, man. Arguing with some people, it can be tiresome because they'll always play the, man, that's the FBI statistics, man. They don't like black people. So you got to, it's annoying, man.
Not only that, but I mean, like for me, my best friend, I've been arguing with this stuff for 3 years, man. And even when he goes and looks for himself, he'd be like, Hawk, you're right, man. And then 2 weeks later, we're having the same discussion again.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's
I've seen that too.
It's very tough arguing with some people, man. They just like, they have ability to like be, willfully daft and things like that.
We memory hold things quick.
Yeah, exactly. What's up, Savrix, man? What's new, man?
Hey, is the mic working now or is it too loud?
Yeah, you're good, man. Just be easy on your breathing, man. You breathe like a, I don't know, you breathe like a fat woman that's like bedridden. Yeah.
Sorry about that, man.
You breathe like one of the people they got to cut a hole in the wall to take them to the hospital and shit.
Oh, sorry about that. Oh, I think it was a fan that was on like full blast, and I don't know, maybe the mic is picking up the airwaves.
Right. But what's up, man?
Hold on, turn off that fan. Okay.
Uh oh, man, you holding me up, man.
Okay, sorry. I wanted to talk about one thing really quick. About you know, whenever people are seeing the racism where it doesn't really exist in that form, or in that moment at all, just like the volleyball thing, that's just the most like recent mass example of it. I was researching something which is magic with a K, and instead of pulling rabbits out of hats and stuff, it's about manipulating consciousness, and the definition is creating something from nothing and believing it to be real or have value. And what they're doing is, the methods being used against us is taking, like, making a belief, a new belief out of nothing and believing it to be real. And the only other example I know like that is a, like, with belief and stuff, is by manipulating perception with a placebo pill. And because if you're told this pill will fix this, and if you know how those trials work, they give people a false pill, like fucking sugar or some shit, and then they give the people like the real drug and stuff. And
called the placebo effect.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, understand. Yeah, and you feel like you've gotten cured because you've gotten something that they told was going to cure you.
Yeah, exactly. And so all the information sources that we pay attention to, all people, all, and all airwaves, that's where we get our perceptions from. And all groups are being exploited in their own unique way. But there's definitely groups that are being used as tools more than others. I don't see a way to stop the polarization, though, because we're dealing with, like, it seems to be the void of reason and truth, actually, itself.
Well, man, hold on, let me stop you, man. Go ahead.
This could turn into like a 6-hour conversation going into this stuff, man.
I just wanted
to say one that small part, and that it's a placebo racism effect. I'll get out now. But it's a form of magic, creating something from nothing.
If I may, Savra gave the answer with his question.
Oh, of course.
He said he doesn't see how to overcome it. Because of the lack of reason.
Because it's illusory. Yeah, everything becomes illusory.
Those are the answers. If you can educate people how to reason and present them with enough truth.
You can't educate people how to reason, though. That's the thing that you got to understand. Like, reason is innate. It's in you. It's something that's you're born with that. It's kind of like
it separates us from animals. Reason?
Well, no, not really, because some people are humans and they can't reason very well. It doesn't separate us from animals. I think that some people were not good at reasoning, and pasty liberals seem to be the lower IQ of the gliders. So the
absolutely,
lower IQ
dude.
Gliders tend to gravitate to that ideology. Yeah, so it's like. You're dealing with two groups. Somebody's just breathing and making loud noise on the mic. But you got two groups that are lower IQ and don't have good reasoning skills. Can y'all mute yourself? Can you mute yourself when you're not speaking? Because it's like a lot that's coming in. I don't care if anybody can't hear it. I can fucking hear it. But you gotta fucking be careful with trying to think that you're gonna teach them, because it's kind of like teaching a hoe. It's like if you meet like a whore at a strip club, and she's fine, and she's your type, and she's sweet as pumpkin pie, and you think you're gonna date this fucking whore and turn her into a fucking chaste woman and shit, have a family with her
from the club.
Yeah, and she could be sweet as pumpkin pie, but she's a fucking whore, and you're never going to be able to have a family with her. You're never going to be able to take her somewhere. If I just take her away from the club, if I take her away from her friends, she's going to find new friends, just like the whole friends. She's going to find a strip club in your fucking area. It just, like, you just can't fucking fix that type of shit. And trying to fix it is something that's only going to be
a fool's errand.
Yeah, waste time. You're going to waste a lot of time.
Well, shit, man. That's not because I've considered myself to be clever, and I just want to. I'm trying to look for other people for answers, and I haven't gotten to learn anything new yet on the subject of how to dampen or stop the social cataclysm. The polarization, and then the union from that. I don't see a way.
Yeah, but what you're doing is still like your reason. You're negotiating with terrorists, and it's not going to fucking work out for you, man.
Oh, like a convert or kill force.
No, yeah, I guess, but it's more like they're
or
doing.
Might that, is right. Might
yeah,
is right.
No,
yeah.
It's more of like. They're doing that. That's what they're doing. And the fact that they're doing that is a red flag and an identifier that they're irredeemable. So it's like, I often talk about like how black women are nine, like mostly woke. Like if you meet a black woman in any one of these cities, they're woke. Well, I mean, if you still live in that city and you still a viable male, viral young guy, you still can date those girls and screw them and shit like that. But you're rarely going to find one that's not woke. So you're just going to be screwing a bunch of woke chicks. Until, you know what I'm saying? Like, and that's kind of how I got to look at it. Like, yeah, if I go to the club.
Yeah, I've recycled a couple girls like that.
Yeah, am I going to not screw this chick because she's woke? Or this
not
big
wokies,
titty,
but
chick because she's woke? No, I'm still going to screw her. But you know what I'm saying? Let's try not to talk about politics. And then when politics come up, we're probably going to argue. We're going to not like each other. We're going to break up. But that's just the facts of it. But trying to convert her? Whoa, that's going to be something that I just don't think you would be able to do. But let's get into this, the main event, man. This woman, I'm going to catch everybody up with this video. All the people that aren't up to breath with this story.
How you doing?
Oh, man, Builder, your mic is fucking up again, man. It's horrible, man. It's dreadful. Whatever you did the other day, you gotta go fix that, man. Go fix that and then come back. But this is to catch you guys up with what's going on with you guys that aren't aware of this story out of Memphis.
This is News Nation Prime with Marnie Hughes.
And good evening to you. I'm Marnie Hughes. Thank you for joining us tonight. We start with some breaking news in an urgent missing case. The search for a mother in Tennessee tonight, police say, was abducted during her early morning run in Memphis. Eliza Fletcher, she goes by Liza, is 5'6", 136 pounds. She is an avid runner, and she was last seen around 4:30 this morning wearing purple shorts and a pink top near the University of Memphis campus. Investigators want the public to see this photo tonight of the SUV. They believe Liza was forced inside. The search for Liza has gained more and more urgency by the minute. The Tennessee Bureau of Investigations and now the FBI, along with the ATF, are on the scene tonight trying to piece together exactly what happened.
We want to find her. We don't know. We don't know what's going on.
A Memphis neighborhood taken over by a police command center. Dogs, helicopters, and now the FBI. All racing to find Eliza Fletcher, a missing teacher, runner, and mother of two who they believe was abducted while out on her morning run. Later reported missing when she didn't return home.
It's very important that if anybody knows the whereabouts of Miss Fletcher to contact the police immediately.
Eliza was captured in this surveillance image wearing a pink tank top and purple shorts before authorities say she was forced into this dark colored SUV that drove off. Her water bottle and phone found nearby.
Everybody's desperately looking for her and the police are here on it. And you can see there's a lot of activity.
Activity that includes searching Fletcher's typical running route, which is near the University of Memphis campus. Her abduction triggering a campus-wide safety alert that now stretches across the city. Tonight, a massive police presence also outside Fletcher's home as her loved ones, school, and church pray for her safe return.
Make sure you hit the PayPal, Cash App, Super Chat. Support the channel. Only one bringing news like this. Support the channel, PayPal, Cash App, Super Chat. Make sure you set up an account on Ock Nation merch store. I'll be giving away some free merchandise next week. But only those guys that have set up an account on the merch store.
Our concern is to locate Miss Fletcher. So if anybody knows where she's at, call the police immediately.
And it is an urgent search tonight. I want to welcome in Lucas Fenton. He's a breaking news reporter at the Commercial Appeal, a Memphis newspaper, and he's been on the case and was just at the scene where investigators are searching tonight. Lucas, thank you. Where are police focusing the search right now, and what's the latest you're hearing?
Well, that's the thing. I mean, right now there's not a lot we do know. Basically, there are two main points where police are gathered. They're gathered at the scene where the water bottle and cell phone was found. At the University of Memphis campus, they've got a mobile command center set up there. But outside of that, really, there's not much to go on, and not much that anyone's hearing.
Tell us more, Lucas, about the description of this car. It's kind of a grainy photo on surveillance. Is that the only image that you know police have?
So there are a couple of images. The one that you have, I believe, was what has been identified as one of the better images. And, you know, that's what's making this such a difficult investigation, I think. There's very hard and not very great camera footage. And that's a big problem for media as well, trying to figure out what this make and model is.
Talk to us about where this happened, where she was taken and put into this SUV near the university campus. Talk about the area. What else is around there?
Yeah, the university campus is kind of wedged between Midtown and what's called East Memphis. So you really have two different kind of districts. You have kind of a residential district on one side and a more commercialized district on the other. Central Avenue kind of, per its name, cuts right through the middle of the main campus. And that is right over there. The picture you're showing now is actually the Earthquake Research Center, which is part of the campus and where they have set up most of the police presence.
There was an alert, Lucas, that went out not only to students, but now it sounds like it is citywide. Tell us about how this is impacting the community, folks on alert and on guard.
You know, for the most part, I have been focused on the crime scenes themselves. I haven't spoken with many community members personally. And so that's kind of where I'm at and focused on is just the case itself.
How big is the police presence? We mentioned the FBI, the ATF, Tennessee top investigators.
Yeah, there are plenty of law enforcement officials both at campus and on out in front of the home. ATF actually has agents embedded with MPD and they work together quite often. So they're pretty much on scene right as MPD is when they were called in at about 7:45 this morning.
I know you and your colleagues have been doing some reporting on who Eliza Fletcher is, her background, her family. What more can you share with us tonight about this young mother?
Well, she was beloved from all accounts, you know, working in the school and along with her grandfather's philanthropy, very much well-known and well-loved within.
We talked about the grandfather's business, Orgill Inc., a $3.2 billion company that's been around since 1847, stood the test of time. She comes from a very, very wealthy family. And their family does a lot of philanthropy, giving away free stuff to some people in the Memphis area. As far as, you know, do for philanthropy. You know, some people, we, you know, we gotta, you know what I'm saying? We need a lot of help, you know what I'm saying? So her family's one of those families that's, you know, does a lot of that stuff.
And they've not yet tied her family to slavery or racism, which is amazing.
Yeah. And they pulled themselves up by the bootstraps, man. So this woman right here, it's just very, very, very sad, man. She's a million, she's the heiress to a $1 billion fortune. And it seemed at a lot of people were thinking that it was some big extravagance. Oh, somebody's holding her for ransom. You know what I mean? This is some plot like out of Dynasty or Falcon Crest or something like that. And I could see how they could think that, you know what I mean? But that wasn't the case.
The circles around her.
She was also a teacher, as I understand.
Yes, she worked over at St. Mary's Episcopal School, and they have issued a statement as well, praying for her safe return.
And part of a well-known family, you mentioned her grandfather. What more have you learned about her family and background?
In terms of the immediate family, not much. They were married in 2014 and had a very, very beautiful wedding over at the Dixon, which is a an art museum that was here that was has had a lot of money come in from her grandfather, who worked as a he has a hardware company. He passed away, but he worked very, very well with the community, and he very much subsidized a lot of public buildings.
Have you all, Lucas, been able to piece together if this was a regular route for Eliza? She was an avid runner. I know that she had run some marathons before. She was out really early this morning. Is this a place that she had run often?
So from what we've been able to gather, campus police who have been on scene, when they issued their broadcast, their safety alert, They said that this was a regular route for her. We haven't heard much on that since, but that was as far as we've heard from police as to whether or not this is a regular route for her.
And you mentioned this earlier, and it's been reported her cell phone and also her water bottle were found. Any other evidence or items left behind?
I do not know about anything else. The cell phone and the water bottle were there. But that's about all we know as far as evidence at the scene.
Being in the community, Lucas, I know law enforcement are focused on finding her, piecing together the details. How forthcoming are they with media in the area as they try to get the message out? One, the alert and urgency in finding her, but letting the
dude,
public know what's going on
all.
In the status of their.
Yeah, man. It's very, very sad, man. Now let's find out. The next step, everybody's caught up. I just wanted to make sure everybody was caught up with what was going on, because some people may not have been aware of this story because it's not being blamed all over the place like you would think a story like this would be blamed all over the place.
This is a very unique outlet of information. This social, just people that have interacted with AK Nation. These attitudes of looking at these situations don't exist anywhere else, man. We talk about things real, man, and we call it as we think it is, you know, like to all of our each individual ability and stuff, and we're all like different, but we all have this, it's very strong, it's a strong power, uniting around finding out the truth and the center point of all this crap.
Yeah, man. So yeah, let me play this video, man. I wouldn't have had slaves if it was if I was around in the 1800s, and but if I was in Africa, I probably would have had slaves because, you know, my grandfather was a chieftain. I come from a family that's you know probably would have had some land and some things like
had
that.
Had to deal with some heavy stuff. Yeah.
So I would have probably had slaves if I was in Africa, but in America, probably not. Let's see.
And right now we have new details on the missing Memphis mom abducted on her morning jog on Friday. New evidence tonight showing the man police have in custody washing both his clothes and the vehicle of interest, Marky Martin.
That's not good, man. That's not good. They got the guy, but they don't have her.
Oh, shit, man.
Anybody who watches, you know, Forensic Files or First 48 or anything, any show dealing with, you know.
That usually means they're done.
Yeah, it's not good.
Is tracking every little detail surrounding.
Smash.
Founding the story
name,
and Marky.
And his name
still
is
no
Sonny.
Word on where Eliza could be.
That's right, Natasha. Still no word. Abston was arrested and charged with especially aggravated kidnapping and tampering with evidence in relation to Fletcher's abduction. Now, according to police records, Abston's DNA was found on a pair of shoes found at the scene.
That's a big son, man. What is it, 73, 74, 74 inches? So he's 6'2". A big old son, man.
Also worth noting, witnesses now coming forward about Abston's suspicious behavior after that kidnapping. Two people say they watched him clean the interior of a GMC Terrain and
clean the interior of a GMC Terrain. Yeesh.
Wash his clothes in the sink of a home. According to police, this is the vehicle of interest in the case, which they located this weekend. Our News Nation Memphis affiliate, WREG, took this video of investigators removing that dumpster at the apartment complex where Abston was seen cleaning his car. Fletcher's family announced a $50,000 reward for any help in finding her, and they also released a video statement thanking police for their search efforts and saying Eliza has touched the hearts of many people.
Y'all might as well go ahead and keep that $50,000, man. It doesn't look like they're going to find her. Builder.
Yeah,
Builder, quickly, man. What's your from your years as an EMT, man? What's your estimation of this girl? Her what's her status right now?
If she doesn't have any water, maybe
4 or 5 days, and she's done. And she's, in the basement, chained up somewhere. And this guy got caught when he was outside doing whatever. They scooped him up. So, 4 or 5 days, she dies of dehydration.
So you think that this son man has her tied up somewhere in the basement?
Well, how do you have a driver? And then my impression of the story was that a van, a driver, and a couple people grabbed her.
No, he was alone. But this guy was alone. He grabbed her. He waited for her. He saw her driving. He pulled over as she passed. He topped out. He grabbed her, threw her in the passenger side. The car didn't move for like 4 minutes, which I'm assuming he was beating the shit out of her, beating her into submission, I guess. And then the car takes off 4 minutes later, and then they caught him, and they don't know where she is.
He could have drugged her and waited for it to kick in, put her in the put the seatbelt on her and drove off.
The family has met with police, and we have shared with them all the information we know. More than anything, we want to see Liza returned home safely.
Yeah, again, her family has come forward offering a $50,000 reward for information in helping to find her. FBI is now working this case. TBI is also working this investigation. Again, it does remain ongoing, and Eliza has not been found. Natasha.
Mark, thank you for watching. Go to newsnationnow.com to find.
Stunner. Now, last week, the biggest story in the country was a lie, but let's just say at the time when they thought it was true, was a glider yelling the sun word at a sister volleyball player during a volleyball match. And that was covered everywhere.
Everywhere.
Emotionally everywhere. Covered too. Like anybody who was covering that story, a news anchor, a reporter, was emotional and very, very, like involved and and invested in that story. It was almost as if like they wanted you to know that this can't happen. And, we got to find, stamp this out wherever it is. The next week, fast forward a week, and now you have a fucking son man who's fucking, in my estimation, kidnapped and killed a heiress to a billion-dollar company. And crickets.
And he didn't even ask for a ransom.
He didn't know who she was.
Exactly. He was just a common criminal who probably should have already been in the clink. And he done randomly snatched this person. And there will be no speeches, no tears, no marches, no riots.
No say her name.
Yeah, none of that.
No kinship for her being to a Memphis woman. Now, none of it.
Yeah. No. None of that. No Me Too. Nothing. This guy. She's dead.
Pardon me a moment, sir. Gen Z is knocking on your door.
Oh, Gen Z.
Your electronic door.
Okay. Thank you.
He outside.
Yeah. What's up? What's up, Gen Z? What's going on, man?
What up?
What man. Up, though?
Yeah, this story is hard, bro. Story is horrible.
You've been now you covered the Rachel Richardson situation.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Like, just talk about the dynamic between that and how crazy that is from one week to the next, and this story is not getting any coverage.
Dude, she's a fucking liar. I mean, it's crazy because everything that she said was fabricated and unchallenged. That's my biggest thing. Like, they're not even like questioning her anymore. The police looked at all the footage. They said they didn't see any evidence of the individual who was banned say anything. And then obviously they didn't say or they didn't see anything else from any other fan, but they couldn't really say that because the priority of their investigation was singled on that one guy and what he did. Another thing that Rachel Richardson said is that after the game, that same guy came up to her and told her to watch her back, but he actually came up to her because he mistakenly came up to her because he thought it was one of his other friends on BYU's volleyball team.
This guy's slow too.
Right. He's obviously slow.
He's a slow guy. And he didn't say anything racist. But what I'm talking about is the dynamic of like a nobody volleyball player garners that much attention at being a sister. And then the next week, a fucking heiress to a $1 billion fortune is just snatched off the streets by some random some man cruising for a bruising and it's cricket.
Yeah.
Insane, man. Don't Be Greedy says it's crazy how cameras on every street corner will solve 99% of crime. If they have camera on every street, they would just need to follow the car. What's up, Brown Sugar? What's happening?
Hey, how y'all doing?
Hi, how are you?
The first Brown Sugar. I'm gonna give you a second to get yourself up off the floor because I know you fell out of your chair when you found out it was a sun man that killed this woman, right?
No, I mean, you know what? Honestly, when you touch on this story of the blogger couple that was murdered, actually, I thought about it for a second. Like, hey, we are capable. Well, not you know, some men are capable of doing such heinous things, such as kidnapping and rape. So. You know, not really, especially knowing that that's what he was in prison for, was for kidnapping.
Yeah.
To Memphis now, and new details tonight about a missing teacher whose abduction Friday was caught on camera. CBS's Elise Preston is there. Elise, good evening.
Good evening, Jerika. Police have not confirmed if their large presence here on the ground or in the air is related to that missing mother's abduction, but they do tell us they are following all leads. Meanwhile, the suspect in this case is behind bars, charged with especially aggravated kidnapping and tampering with evidence.
A community is desperate for answers tonight after 34-year-old Eliza Fletcher was abducted while jogging early Friday morning near the University of Memphis. Police sharing these photos with the public in hopes someone might help locate her. But according to police records obtained by CBS News, additional unreleased surveillance video shows the well-known teacher violently abducted. Police say this man, Cleotha Abston, waited for the Memphis mother to run by him before grabbing her and forcing her into his SUV. Investigators say they found her phone and his sandals at the scene. Cell records showed Abston's phone in the area at the same time of Fletcher's disappearance. Her family pleading for her safe return.
And this is, I feel bad for the family because she's, look, if he's fucking cleaning up blood out of the fucking car and they have him and they don't have her.
Builder it's over
that strange scenario. She's somewhere tied up in some basement building. You watch too many goddamn movies.
That's the kind of shit I meant by I just hope she didn't suffer, as if, like, yeah, she might still be like, I hope that kind of scenario didn't happen, but it seems like more that it is.
Y'all watch the movies too much, man.
Yeah, so be, bro.
Some man ain't live tying you up, but this ain't, what's it, NCIS or some shit like that. This is just.
That nigga got rid of her within the first 4 hours.
Exactly. Yeah.
He was stabbing her in the car as soon as he got her.
And yeah. You know what? It'll be weird if he was connected to the other two murderers or the other two women bodies that they found at the cemetery.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the facts. Yeah, we talked about that last night. They found the two women at the cemetery dead in the same city in the last month.
We believe someone knows what happened.
Well, they were already in a cemetery.
Miriam Smith attends church with Fletcher.
She's got a lot of tenacity. She's strong.
Outside of Fletcher's Memphis home, police collected evidence. They also hauled this dumpster away from the home of Abston's brother,
Records show the suspect's brother told police he spotted the 38-year-old suspect scrubbing down the inside of his car with cleaner and, quote, acting strange.
So the brother's already cooperating with authorities, man. He's already given that's listen, the brother says he's acting strange. He was scrubbing out the inside of his car. She's gone, man. She's not tied up in the basement. There's no
there's no dastardly plan.
it's unfortunately, man, and I feel bad because if this was the other way around, if this was a glider who had done this to a sister,
right?
God.
Oh, the stunt community, like their comments under the news Facebook channel, it's like they're angry because she getting all this attention. So they're like posting other stunt women that was missing and saying, "What about them?"
But they only care now. Here's the thing:
you called it though. You called it. You said we're gonna make this about us somehow.
Yep. Hypocrisy.
Well, here's the thing: they only care about those sun women now. They could have been posting those sun women that were missing.
Do they really care, or do they care because everybody they'll look bad if they don't care? Like they have
to. Nah, it's not that. They're just
okay.
And those women who are missing, they were killed by sun men.
Exactly.
Bingo.
Yeah.
Figure.
And they also they believe that the man, you know, they don't think he could have did it on his own. They're saying that the husband hired him. I mean, a lot of women do.
Whoa, really?
I mean, a lot of women in Memphis normally get murdered by their husbands. Yeah. But I don't think it's this the case anymore. I really think dude was just a creep, and with his history of kidnapping, I think he was just kidnapping this woman and probably didn't know who she was. Just seen a woman jogging and just took her. Didn't know that she was a billionaire.
Can you put that in the back chat, the link to the Facebook page?
Yes, I can try to get it.
Facebook is just so damn toxic.
Yeah, well, some people are toxic because that's just to throw that man in it when you have evidence. And that's one thing about some people that's so frustrating, like I was trying to tell Savricks earlier, is trying to reason with them. Like, you're literally trying to, like, you know what I mean? Like, make sense of it with them. They have the guy. His brother's already snitched on him. They have footage of the guy kidnapping her. And they want to throw some extravagant thing that ties the husband in on it.
Yeah.
What's up, Cook County? Cook County in the building.
Yo, what's up, y'all?
What's the likelihood that this woman is still alive, man?
Yeah, zero. What's your opinion?
Zero.
Zero.
It takes a lot to be able to charge somebody with something like this and for them not to have anything. And for them to publicize it, you know what I'm saying, his face and his image and everything like that. The police and FBI, they already know.
Yeah, if they're cleaning up blood, if he's giving him detail in his own car, like, come on, man, like, she's done, man. But let's get back into this, man.
The 38-year-old suspect scrubbing down the inside of his car with
maybe
clear,
a 10% chance. I'd say
strange. Now, court records show the suspect has a criminal past here in Tennessee. He pleaded guilty to especially aggravated kidnapping in 2001. Meanwhile, Fletcher's family...
He pleaded guilty to especially aggravated kidnapping in 2001. So that probably means he did a stretch.
Exactly.
Yeah, he just got out. They said he got out like in 2019. So he kidnapped a lawyer.
Okay, so he did about a dub. Maybe 18 years in prison, and then he comes home and he commits the same crime. And listen, the prosecutor got 18 years out of him for the first kidnapping. You got to commend her for that. I mean, it's hard to get these sun men.
True.
You know,
that was an 01 though.
Exactly. She did her job.
It was a different era.
And they voted her out too.
The polarization isn't
quite how it is now, though. It's like at its extreme polarities.
She got it. Yeah, she. But I mean, I don't see how you could have prevented that. I mean, what do you want him to get a life sentence? They're not going to give a Southern man a life sentence for that, for kidnapping somebody. Then they gave him 18 years apparently, and he did his time. He did his time. He came home. I mean, I don't see how you. That's just this was unavoidable. he's out. He did his time.
Guilty to especially aggravated kidnapping in 2001. Meanwhile, Fletcher's family is offering a reward to her safe return. Jerika?
Still so many questions. Elise Preston reporting from Memphis tonight. Thank you.
More than 48 hours.
Brown Sugar, wouldn't you say this? The neighborhood that she was jogging in was pretty dangerous too?
No. The neighborhood like she lived in, I mean, it's a pretty decent neighborhood. It's just like not far from it. It's dangerous, but like I said, a lot of gliders, they jog 4-5 o'clock in the morning. Like,
yeah,
it's normal to see that.
Definitely.
It's just normal.
But you know why they do that?
Oh, she, yeah.
Why they do that though, right?
I don't know.
Because the neighborhood is safe, and they have two reasons. They work, okay. So when a glider neighborhood, especially those upper wealthy glider, they work. The only time you can run is in the morning before work. Then
you have to be in the chat shouting smash.
Yeah, smash this one. Yeah, she looks. Of course, but
she'll smash you, man.
Rhea is very popular, y'all. Yeah.
That's one hell of a word.
Who said that? Did the British guy say that?
Yeah.
That's hilarious, man. You're awesome.
But these neighborhoods are safe. These glider neighborhoods are safe. Nobody's gonna jump out the bushes and grab you. This was not someone from their community that did this. If you live in a glider neighborhood, it's relatively safe to jog.
Like, I'm just saying, like, knowing the area like I know it, the area that she's in being close to the university. I mean, I just know the area near the. I've never been to this particular neighborhood, but I know the university is sketchy.
Yeah, that's
like in the South Memphis area. That's kind of dangerous over there where that man was living in. But I mean, my thing is, if they wanted to get her, they would have been got her. Like, no one even knew she was a billionaire. You know what I mean? If some men would have been kidnap her and held her for ransom.
Yeah, I don't even think some men really operate like that. Really, if she had been held, if it had been a ransom, then I would have thought it was a glider. So like, I don't even think some men operate like that really, unless it's like a drug, like they'll kidnap a drug dealer or something like that. But nothing like this.
Yeah, that's too complex.
Yeah, it takes too much planning. And this one right here though. He said, CA says he did 20 years and his victim tried advocating for him to do no time. Please put that in the back chat, CA, if you got that. I want to see that because that's crazy. But yeah, let's see what this lovely lady has to say, man.
More than 48 hours after Eliza Fletcher's abduction, investigators returned here to this South Memphis apartment complex after detectives say her accused abductor, Cleotha Abson, came here to hide evidence. Dramatic chain of events in the Eliza Fletcher abduction. This exclusive video shows a dumpster being towed away from the Longview Garden apartments in South Memphis with a police cruiser closely trailing behind.
We ever had nothing like this over here.
According to this arrest affidavit, 38-year-old Cleotha Abston is accused of kidnapping 34-year-old Fletcher while she was jogging in the University of Memphis area along Central Avenue around 4:30 Friday morning. This is the last known snapshot of the beloved wife, mother of two young boys, and St. Mary's teacher running in a pink athletic top and purple shorts. According to court records, surveillance video shows Abston waited for Fletcher to pass by in a GMC Terrain when he ran aggressively toward her and forced her into the passenger side of the vehicle. Detectives say there appeared to be a struggle, and Abston sat in the parking lot for 4 minutes before driving off with Fletcher.
Do you think he killed her then or just beat her like silly the way he could didn't take advantage of it. Yeah,
I think he took her where he could finish the job on her before he finished the job on her.
I think he was raping her then.
Yeah, I think he was just beating the shit out of her. Cause she probably
I think he just got her in there and he got it all out. He just beat the shit, beat her silly until she stopped fighting, and then he started scrambling in his mind, okay, where am I gonna go? And then he took her off where he took her, and he probably raped her too.
Oh yeah, definitely. That was the reason for it. I mean, I think that was this wasn't just to beat the shit out of some white woman. This was to rape someone.
It's base desire.
Yeah. So
before driving off with Fletcher. He left behind Champion slide sandals at the scene that officers sent off to the Tennessee Bureau of Investigation.
He left his slides. He left his slides on the scene. I mean, we're talking about a guy that's just like reckless. This type of recklessness, y'all talking about some goddamn master plan. Like, this is just a reckless son, man. It just happened to be that the person who was jogging when he was hunting was the heiress to a $1 billion fortune. It just happens.
Yeah, I don't think the husband had anything to do with this. He wouldn't dare hire Cleotha.
Yeah, what the hell would the husband find Cleotha?
You know,
them hauling off the dumpster makes it more likely to me. She's probably in that dumpster and they didn't it out there.
They would have told you that they recovered her and the family wouldn't have had that reward. That dumpster, don't let that dumpster fool you. That dumpster could be something as simple as like his clothes was in there or her clothes was in there. They just don't want to touch it. So you got to take it to a lab.
Or the rags from him cleaning.
Yeah, it could be anything. It could be anything. What he cleaned the car with.
Anything.
So if they found
her,
they would have told you. They would have told you.
Yeah, yeah. They would have. They're not going to keep the family in suspense and her body's in that fucking thing. Yeah. This is just a regular old son, man, just ran into a billionaire. It's like a joke. A billionaire and a son man walking down the street. I mean, it's just, I don't know, man. Crazy.
Investigation. Investigators say DNA tied him to the crime. As for the connection to this dumpster, it was towed away from the complex where Mario Abston, Cleotha's brother, lives. He and another witness told officers hours after the abduction, Cleotha was acting strange when he came to the complex to wash his clothes in the sink and clean the interior of his car.
He washed his clothes in the sink.
That's fucking bizarre.
Yeah,
that's he came there afterwards and started, so he dumped her somewhere.
She's probably in the Mississippi River.
I was going to say either in the river or one of those dumpsters in that vicinity.
I'm going with the river or some, like, you know what I'm saying, wooded area.
That's the some people go to areas, the river.
Or that cemetery, maybe, or somewhere else, because she might be on a parkway somewhere. He might have pulled up on the side of a parkway and just threw her ass out the car or something. Or I don't think this son man took a lot into where he dumped her. You know what I'm saying? I don't think he dug a hole or anything like that. I think they was going to find her body, like a jogger's going to find her body or something like that.
I think he wanted to rape her or something, man, but he accidentally killed her in the car in that first 4 minutes myself. That's what I think.
Yeah, I mean, or he could have purposely, like, once you rape that woman, like, might as well just kill her. Like,
and sometimes a woman can die during rape.
Exactly.
So she could have just died just from getting raped, just from the shock of it all.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Can I say something about the behavior, though, between the two sides? I noticed that one side is, which is mainly everybody, against, you know, the Democrat and the Marxist. But both sides kind of...
Come on, Builder, man. I'm going to start calling you goddamn Builder, man. You're taking a long time to get your thoughts.
Oh, no. Sorry, bro. Never mind. Yeah. There's a link that I sent that explains it. Man. Sorry.
Get your thoughts together and then talk, man. You like a, I don't know what the hell wrong with you, man. But you better, you good with the comments. You know?
Adolescent builder.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, man. Like, build the time traveler and shit.
I'm
like
well learned, but not well spoken, I guess.
Builder went into a time machine and shit and came back when he was fucking 20 something because his mic.
This is car with floor cleaner. Court records say investigators believe Fletcher suffered serious injuries in the abduction. And based on these witness statements, Cleotha cleaned up blood left behind. His brother Mario is now facing unrelated gun and drug charges.
So, just a wow. Criminal family, man.
The whole family.
Yeah, man. She.
Hey, what's funny? Hey, what's funny about this is, you know how he's facing those charges?
Go ahead, tell us.
This all became because his brother came to his house and they did a search warrant on the house.
Yep.
Exactly. And then he told on him.
And he should have, because his brother brought that heat to his house.
Right. Yeah, he brought that to his house, and now he didn't get the goddamn gun charge, the drug charge.
Yep, exactly.
And they gonna shake down a whole apartment complex. Everybody going to jail.
Man, it's all that white bitch's fault.
Yep. If she wouldn't have been jumped, I promise you they probably think.
They're saying it. They're saying it's her fault. She shouldn't have been jogging out that time of night with those type of clothes on. And
what's the name of the news channel, Brown Sugar? That you
it was Fox 13 News.
Fox 13.
Let's put it this way. She shouldn't have been jogging out there. She shouldn't have been jogging out there in those clothes without a strap on her.
When it goes to trial, his lawyer is going to be arguing that they were having a secret affair for months anyway, and it was all arranged.
Oh yeah, like
right.
That.
Yeah, they can say that about. Yeah, you're right. She's dead, so I mean, it's not like she could, say that's not true.
Yeah, but they still gonna look at his cell phone records and her cell phone records.
Yeah, it's always gonna be paper trail. It ain't that easy.
Nah, it ain't.
I ain't gonna stop them lying.
Yeah, this is crazy, man. This is bizarre, man. Some people are just terrible people if they're online doing this shit that you're saying. It's on the website of the story underneath the Fox
News. Yeah, it's like on Fox 13 News Facebook page.
Okay. These people are just horrible people if they're doing this, because if this was reversed, it would be like fucked. The whole country would be in turmoil if this was reversed, man.
Ben Crump,
if this was reversed, it'd be on ESPN.
Yeah, exactly. They would be talking about ESPN.
Doctor, whatever that little light skin dude, you like to play him.
But you'd have to find a Sun woman jogging.
I mean,
that's like seeing a damn unicorn.
That's low, man.
No, it's not. Nah, I really some, like some women we don't jog, but we're jogging in the park. Like, we're not.
What?
I'm in a city street?
Oh,
yeah, we know.
I think some women get a bad rap. That's like that manosphere shit. Like, I see some women juggling plenty, but
I live in a subdivision with a lot of Sun women. Don't see it's a blue moon when I see one jogging.
Oh God, I'm trying to figure out what y'all talking about.
I mean, I'm mostly glider now, but well, the Sun women over here jog.
Well, the Sun women do. I guess, well, it's two types of some women, but the some women that will jog, they're not going to jog like on the street. They're going to go to like, you know, Shelby Farms and jog.
Nobody jogs here.
Okay, let me move on.
Shop for neighbors.
I wouldn't expect Mario to do nothing like that. His brother, he give me creepy vibes. Like, he'll look at you some type of way.
You heard that? Yeah, listen to this sister, man, his son sister, man.
Verse. I wouldn't expect Mario to do nothing like that. His brother, he give me creepy vibes. Like, he'll look at you some type of way.
Cleotha Abstin was later arrested at another apartment complex in Hickory Hill, where investigators say they located the GMC Terrain believed to be used in Fletcher's kidnapping. According to court records, Abson is set to make his first court appearance on Tuesday. Now reporting.
Well, he go to court Tuesday. Wow. I hope they find her by Tuesday. Geez, man, let me go to this Facebook. These fucking son book. This fucking bullshit they doing over here. So this one person says, this is the comment section underneath the story. This one person says, I wonder how much her husband's paying him or his family. And
shut the fuck up, dude. It makes sense to plenty of people here. It's just very dense information, and it takes a lot of explaining. And there's no modern translation for this information. Placebo racism effect? That's unheard of. And the only reason I was able to figure that out is because I put together information that's separated by centuries. Okay, solo bitch? So if you don't understand it, that's your individual psyche's ability to not recognize it. So fuck you. All right?
He went for somebody in the chat. Reading the chat.
Okay, yeah. Don't do that. Stay with
you. Got smoke for him.
Yes. Just type to them in the chat, man. You don't do that.
I didn't know if I was supposed to squash that shit immediately, man.
Yeah, just take it easy.
But yeah, I'll do that more discreetly, brother.
Yeah. Yeah, so this one says, wow, what the fuck? DNA could be in a slide. Was he bleeding or something? Let me see. Some people to try to put this on the husband. This one said he shouldn't have been out of prison. This is so sad.
That's at least somebody with some sense in there.
Yeah, I mean he's a bad guy, man. They're saying this woman's missing.
I told you they're about to post all the black women missing now.
Tamika Means, if seen, please. So this woman, this is the thing. You just had a week of a woman that got called the N-word by a ghost at a volleyball game, but yet they're still trying to act like, oh, there's some difference in coverage. We don't get treated the same. You get treated better when you get called the N-word than this one's getting treated missing, getting killed. It's so crazy, man, to some people. This is why I don't argue with some people. I had to leave Twitter alone because you get on Twitter and you start arguing with these some people and you realize, like, you're getting
dumb. Whole days of your life will go by and you'll still be arguing with these motherfuckers. Yeah.
Exactly. They don't live in reality.
Yeah, they just, I don't know. It's a difference. Like, you can have compassion, but at the same time, I mean, facts is facts. The truth is the truth.
Yeah.
It's creating it from nothing, and they believe it to be real, just projecting onto other people. I'm going to try to say things more simpler.
Yeah. This is crazy. I got something else I want to show y'all. Make sure you hit the PayPal, Cash App, Super Chat. Support the channel, man. This is Eliza Fletcher, man. I'm fearing that, you know, she's no longer with us. I think she's kicked the can, man.
Hey, Ock, did you see a Latina? Wanting to get into that thugging game was shooting a pistol out the car window with an extendo clip on it, driving along in Bexar County.
Right now, we have new details just on the missing Memphis mom abducted on her morning jog on Friday.
You mean just randomly shooting out the window or shooting at people?
Just randomly shooting out the window up in the air.
Wow.
Apparently it came to rest in a 10-year-old's bedroom right next to where he was.
Yeah, I saw that.
Thank God.
Well, that's crazy. Here goes some. Memphis is a crazy city. So it's like, if you're a glider in Memphis right now, you might want to get out, because all these stories that I've uncovered are from a few, the last few months.
That I'm gonna show they're you oblivious to it.
Some man kidnapped him, man. Killed by someone he.
Yeah, this is crazy.
New at six, a man kidnapped and killed by someone he knew, according to the district attorney's office. Even more troubling, the victim was a double amputee in a wheelchair.
And now one of the suspects has been indicted in the murder. WREG's Bria Jones joins us live now after talking with someone who knew both the victim and the suspect.
Yeah, Shay and Greg, this community member says stories like this are just tragic, but we can all do our part to make a difference.
His own viral saying,
Memphis, 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 the most beautiful land in the world.
Donnie Young is a true champion for the Bluff City, even when tragedy hits home. He owns this training facility next to the community grocery on Horn Lake Road, the area where investigators say 41-year-old Romario Prince Akins, a double amputee, was abducted at gunpoint back in August.
He was a normal person, you know, a respected person. I know him. It's a hurting thing. It's a shocking thing.
According to the district attorney's office, he was kidnapped by this man, 24-year-old Jerome Nichols, who was an acquaintance. Investigators say surveillance video shows two men putting Akins in an SUV after punching him. They drove off, leaving the wheelchair. Young, who works security at the gas station across the street, says he wasn't around at the time, but always looks out for the community.
I make it my business every day, you know, to secure this area, you know, to secure this area every day, 24/7.
Listen, man, salute to this brother, man. Like, I mean, like,
even picking up trash on the side of the highway.
Picking up trash, securing the neighborhood. And you got to understand, man, this area right here, Memphis, give them an idea of this area right here, Stunner.
Yes, I do. But Brown Sugar know it even better than I do. She know it's so much litter out there. If he just dedicated his life to picking up litter, he would do nothing else.
He'll be tired.
But it's a rough spot.
All day long.
The type of characters that are out here are not like, because you know how like people try to say, oh yeah, you know, yeah, I know some rough characters. Like, nah, you don't know me. Like these types.
This man is in the Shark Tank.
Exactly. He's in the trench. He's not. This is different. This is not Paul Blart right here, man. This is like Paul Blart meets Blade. You know what I'm saying? This dude is a real serious cat, man, to do this over there. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't care that he's packing, even though it's good that he's packing, because that's he needs to pack. But that's not something that they're going to see and be like, well, you know. And he has to tell some men to leave. Like, if he's the security guard over there, he has to routinely tell some men, you can't do that. Stop. You know what I mean? Leave or don't come. You know what I mean? It's a tough job, man. Salute to this brother, man. I ain't going to lie, man. This brother's a true hero for the community, man.
After punching him, they drove off, leaving the wheelchair. Young, who works security at the gas station across the street, says he wasn't around at the time, but always looks out for the community.
I make it my business every day, you know, to secure this area, you know, to secure this area every day, 24/7.
2 days later, police say a father and son riding four-wheelers found Akins' body here in this wooded area of West Shelby Drive. He'd been shot more than half a dozen times. This week, a grand jury indicted Nichols on multiple felonies, including premeditated first-degree murder and aggravated kidnapping and robbery. All shocking news to Young, who trained Nichols as a kid.
To be truthful with you, you know, he never had that type of nature or showed the type of character or behavior. You know, I don't see it because I knew him as a child, despite all things going on. Memphis is still a beautiful place.
Nichols is being held without bond. Investigators are still searching for that second man seen abducting Akins. If you have any information, call Crime Stoppers at 528-CASH. We're now reporting live outside 201 Poplar, Bria Jones, WREG News, Channel 3.
Akins must have seen some.
A $500,000 bond, accused of robbing a man at gunpoint and trying to kidnap a woman off an East Memphis street. Charles
Wood. What?
It's like someone popping, like their mic is making.
Yeah, it sounds like they're hitting their mic against the desk or something.
Okay, but the video is not popping though, right?
I think it may be the video.
My a Memphis man is locked up on nearly a $500,000 bond, accused of robbing a man at gunpoint and trying to kidnap a woman off an East Memphis street. 21-year-old Charles Williams is facing a slew of charges. WREG's Melissa Moon is live outside the Shelby County Jail with more on what police are saying about the crimes. Melissa?
Well, Williams is charged with several counts of robbery. He's also charged with kidnapping and evading arrest. We talked to one witness who ended up rescuing one of those victims.
An East Memphis neighborhood on edge after a woman was nearly kidnapped during a morning walk.
I work from home, and
I mean, listen, man, this is
this is a trend, Doc.
That's what I'm trying to show you.
Yeah, they just started doing all these.
So I'm trying to show you, like, this is just something. This is one of the games they play there. Like in Houston, they do the follow home robberies, you know, in certain cities they have, you know, different types of crime. This is just seems to be something that the Sunmen do here, man.
It just never occurred to me that something like this could happen at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Police say the victim was on Alexander Street, just north of Central, when a man jumped out of a car, pointed a gun at her, demanded money, and tried to pull her inside the vehicle.
I was working from home, and I heard someone yelling, help, help, help.
This neighbor on Alexander, who didn't want to be identified, says after he heard the woman's cries for help, he ran outside and was able to scare off the attacker.
I started yelling at him, and I guess it was enough to make him let her go, and she came to me and was obviously very distraught.
Police say
salute to this glider, man. This glider, you know, we talk about how like lame and goddamn fucking impotent glider men are in this generation.
Nah, he crazy. Don't salute him. His ass supposed to be gone.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like he doesn't realize like
I
that.
Mean, maybe not. I mean, if the Sun Man wasn't, I don't think he was just trying to kill nobody. So
it's all about reaction. It's just like he tried this, he did this, and then it's time to shoot because
exactly
you surprised me.
Exactly.
I might be committing a crime, but boom, you surprised me. Pow pow. That's how it goes. It ain't like no thinking to it. It's not they don't come there with a plan of this how it's gonna go. They don't think of plan B or if they react with he loaded, when he got a gun, nothing like that. It's just impulse. It's just like just random reaction with emotion.
I agree with you, Cook County. I think, you know, Brown Sugar, and you know, you give the Sun Man a lot of benefit of the doubt, which is good. We need that on this panel, man, because I mean, most people are pretty much like red pilled about the Sun Man here.
It's hidden amongst, though, remember?
Yeah,
it's hard to remember it's just, sometimes.
It's just with Brown Sugar, I see it every day.
Yeah,
I just see it. I see it every day, all day, Brown Sugar. I mean, I was like you. I was.
Yeah, it's just like you. It's worse than you think, Brown Sugar. It's worse. But yeah, salute, man. Hit the PayPal, Cash App, Super Chat, man. Let's try to get some new people supporting the channel today, man. The same tax base from Op Nation supporting the channel every show. Let's try to get some new people, some wall watchers, and some people that never supported to hit that PayPal, hit that Cash App, or hit that Super Chat.
Came to me and
share that link.
Was obviously very distraught.
Police say 21-year-old Charles Williams was on a crime spree when he tried to grab the woman. They say 2 days earlier, he took this Nissan at gunpoint from a man at an apartment complex on Southern in the middle of the afternoon. The man showed us the car but didn't want to talk. Police say they found it and Williams about a half mile from where the woman was attacked. They say he wrecked it trying to get away. People in the victim's neighborhood are relieved he was caught.
It's really changed my sort of daily habits.
The man who came to the woman's rescue.
But is it going to change your voting habits?
No. No.
They voted. They got to vote DA. It's too late now. They done voted their man in.
Oh, that white guy?
Yeah, I told you he's trying to raise the juvenile age to 25.
Yeah, I heard about that. That's something that's really young gaining steam, because they say your brain doesn't fully develop to 25. So now, some men being treated as juveniles. Could you imagine the juvenile system? Because you know the way they treat juveniles is just catch and release. It's call your parents.
Yeah, it's a slap on the wrist.
Yeah, and your parents can pick you up. Could you imagine some men being treated like that until they're 25?
That's sick.
This country won't make it, man.
Like, that's super sick because, like, juveniles know, like, they be, they know. Can you imagine? They know at 15 that it can't be nothing done to them. Exactly. So at 25? At 25, without the juvenile record, I've seen guys with 36 arrests from 18 to 25.
We've seen guys with way more.
I'm talking about from their adult history, 18 to 25. Yeah. They got 8, 9, 10 felony convictions.
I know some men that got locked up every fucking weekend, man.
I'd say the average is probably 20.
Yeah, definitely. Salute to Deluxe 247, man. He says, great stream, man. He says the Cash App. Salute to you, man. You the real MVP, man. Let's see. This is something that's going on here, and I just wanted to show y'all this trend.
At the right time.
I was scheduled to go to the office that day, and I decided to work from home. So I do feel fortunate that I was here to do something. It wasn't much, but it was enough to make him let her go.
Police say Williams took that woman's cell phone. The other victim we talked to says he also took his phone as well as his debit card and forced him to give him his PIN. In downtown Memphis, Melissa Moon, WREG, News Channel 3.
Hey, quick question for you.
Reflecting on a nightmare.
So what would they be saying about a glider walking around open carrying, picking up trash and telling Sun men that they couldn't be around over it?
Oh my God, fucking Ku Klux Klan member, man. Racist, goddamn. He on some police ass shit.
Oh, yeah, they'll project everything they hate onto that person.
Yeah, that glider.
They don't feel comfortable.
Yeah, that glider would definitely
I don't feel comfortable with him walking around with his gun out. It's scary.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would not fly.
Reflecting on a nightmare, this teenage girl says that she was kidnapped, stabbed, and left for dead. Hello, I'm Greg Hurst.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Scurlock. The horrific chain of events spanning two states, and as WREG's Andrew Allison reports, the girl says she knows the people who allegedly did this to her.
I just look at it like it's a second chance at life.
Clinging to her faith.
Day by day.
17-year-old China Kirkland is trying to regain her sense of security after deputies say she was kidnapped, stabbed, and left for dead.
It is traumatizing.
She says the horrific chain of events started in Helena, West Helena, Arkansas, when a group of people she knows tracked her to a friend's house and held her at gunpoint around 8:30 Thursday night.
They had some weed, some marijuana, and they thought I had them set up to get it stolen, or they thought I stole it.
She says they bound and gagged her, then put her in the trunk of a car.
I was just laying in the trunk, wondering, fearing for my life, really.
Deputies say they drove her into the woods about 20 miles away in Tunica County, Mississippi, near Jeffries and Dundee Road, then threw her on the ground.
And I was trying to scream for my life with my mouth with duct tape.
She says one of her abductors stabbed her more than a dozen times in her neck, stomach, back, and shoulders, so she played dead, hoping he would stop.
I think that was a very smart move on her end. I'm so glad that she...
Goddamn police chief.
Who would have thought playing dead would get her out of it, man?
Fuck, man.
Yeah, I mean...
Yeah, normally come back and shoot him in the head.
When you're a woman, though, you're just trying to survive the encounter, man. You're not trying to fucking overpower. There's no way she could overpower two guys, man. So it was the right thing to do, I guess. But it's hard to play dead with someone stabbing you.
Very smart move on her end. I'm so glad that she decided to do that. I think that could be the only thing that actually saved her life.
Deputies say she waited for them to leave, then ran out to the road and flagged down a couple of drivers who stopped to help her and called 911. First responders flying her by helicopter to Regional Medical Center in Memphis.
I thought, I'm not going to make it because I was bleeding out.
Deputies arrested 29-year-old Tevin Randall and are currently investigating four persons of interest who are still on the streets tonight. And she's scared.
It worries me, but I pray.
The case being handled by Tunica and Phillips County.
They had my baby down in that black
firing. They were kicking her, stabbing her. I want them punished. Period.
You believe justice will be served?
Oh, yes, sir.
But the haunting memories are unlikely to fade anytime soon. In Helena, West Helena, Arkansas, Andrew Ellison, WRG News, Channel 3.
This is a suburb of Memphis, right?
Any bets on the identity of the people that stopped and helped her?
Oh, Gladys. Definitely was Gladys that probably.
Hey, Tunica is where they got the
Glad she survived. Right?
She's tough.
Yeah, Tunica has the casinos, yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's probably
it's
down along the river across the border from Memphis.
Kidnapping. We'll let you know if anyone else is arrested.
Now some disturbing details revealed in the recent conviction of a serial rapist linked to multiple untested rape kits. Michael Love raped seven Memphis women he met online or in person between 2008 to 2015. Prosecutors say he would randomly kidnap and abduct women, drive her to a dead-end street, force her to have sex, and then leave her helpless. One of the victims was a minor. Love's cases were not linked until he was arrested back in 2015. Officers took his DNA and matched it with sex assault kits that are still being tested in connection to Memphis's backlog battle. Love will be sentenced in August.
Yeah, so all these are over the last, these stories. Are
can we sentence him to a rope?
Yeah, listen, man, this is...
We are going on hour 18 in the case of a woman who went for a run early this morning and never returned. Thank you for being here. I'm Carrie Sharp. Rory is off tonight. A statewide search is happening right now for Eliza Fletcher. The 34-year-old mother of two was out running near the University of Memphis this morning around 4:30 when investigators say she was abducted. News Channel 5's Araceli Crescencio has more on the search multiple agencies are now involved in, as well as ways to stay safe.
Yeah, the Tennessee Bureau of Investigation and the FBI are now working together to find 34-year-old Eliza Fletcher. She was out running at around 4 a.m. when she was forced into an SUV and kidnapped. Police say this is the car believed to be involved. It's a dark-colored SUV. It's not clear what direction the driver went. Fletcher was wearing a pink shirt and purple shorts at the time of her abduction. With each passing hour, law enforcement's job becomes more difficult, which is why friends are urging anyone who might know something to speak up.
Where everybody's desperately looking for her, and the police are here on it, and you can see there's a lot of activity. So we're just, if you know anything or saw anything early this morning, we're just asking for you to come forward.
This high profile case has many people thinking about their running routine and ways to reduce their risk. Experts say it all starts with being aware of your surroundings and making sure you're not an easy target. There are countless safety risks that exist when running alone.
Does anybody remember after Ahmaud Arbery when black men, full-body, able-bodied black men were talking about they don't feel safe jogging?
Yeah, I remember that.
All the
you did the story bullshit. On them, right? With the black men.
Bullshit. The white man would come up with a pickup truck and take me in. All this bullshit that niggas was talking, man. And these women, these white women have a literal real threat. Like, they have a real threat. Those black men, nothing.
The thing is, they're probably more in danger from jogging with the other Sun men there to protect them than they are from anything else, because they get into an argument. Oh, my, it could be dangerous.
Yeah. Go ahead.
I was going to say, it looks like from all of these reports, man, it don't matter what tribe you from. If you female and you out, just out, you need to have your head on the swivel.
Yeah, definitely. Salute the Black Trunks. He says the Cash App, he says, salute the Ock Nation and Black Gen Z 100.
There are countless safety risks that exist when running alone, but experts say avoiding danger starts with situational awareness.
So as you're looking around and you see somebody approaching you, at 21 feet out, you need to already start to think, do I need to run, hide, or fight?
Many times people don't react quickly when confronted with danger because
I agree with that. I totally agree with that.
But if they do that, they racist.
You have to discriminate on the appearance of someone.
But here's the thing. Eliza was running. The sun man pulls the car over to the side of the road ahead of her. So he's parked on the side of the road. She sees a car just pull over on her route. If she should have right then turned the other way and jumped the way across the street, at least cross the street, but maybe turn the other way. So that if you cross the street and then he comes over there, then you know that's confirmation that he's following you.
You know, I think not wanting to be called racist is killing her people.
Exactly.
First thing I think is, exactly, what a fucking dumbass.
I see gliders all the time moseying into situations because I think they're afraid to use common sense.
Just kissing mosey ass.
Mosey, that's funny. Yeah, man, it's definitely, man. She I'm sure she was thinking, I'm sure it hit her mind, like, oh, when she saw that fucking car pull over, like that, like let's just say he pulls over, like maybe let's just say 1,000 feet in front of her, or maybe 500 feet in front of her, and she's running, and she's like, oh, she notices that. She's like, oh shit, what is this? And I know when he hopped out that car and grabbed her up, I know she was like, fuck.
Dude, the unprovoked attacks is what kills me, dude. I can watch almost anything and I can take it, but it's just, there's something about that that's just, there's no core reasoning behind it, man. It's just, it's evil.
Yeah, it's fucking crazy, man.
Over time, you'll get used to it, man. It's all good.
Yeah, salute the old school, man. Old school says Memphis is really putting forth the effort to be in the top five. Yeah, I mean, listen, man, and those weren't all the kidnapping stories. I just picked the best ones from the last couple of months. There's a lot of kidnapping going on in that city. It's just like those sun men are fucking out of control down there, man.
They've never thought about facing it.
But a lot of times we just look at TV and we don't stop to pause. So our brain never makes that connection to what would I do?
Pat Thurmond, a self-defense expert, says people need to have a safety plan on hand.
Make sure you have some kind of self-defense tool with you. Mm-hmm. So, you know, pepper spray is a good one for distance.
In the case of an attempt.
Yeah, had she had some pepper spray, like had she had that and that guy jumps out, now she's got to fucking spray him. Of course, she can't be like, okay, stop, no. And then he punches her. Yeah,
she at least has an irritant.
Yeah, because if he punches her before she sprays it, she's going to sleep. That big 6'2" sun man from the Ben and Jerry.
If she would have sprayed him, he'd have been looking like that saucy blood in that video.
Exactly. You see the effect of it. You see, like, that shit fucks you up. So, like, yeah.
Especially if it gets in his eyes.
She could have gotten away. Just,
I don't let my wife move without it.
Yeah, just from having some mace. She didn't need a fucking gun. She don't need to be running
like
around
an ink cloud for a squid.
Yeah, she just some mace, man. She could have saved her fucking life, man. Just a fucking, and this shit cost like what, $20?
Or if she would have carried a little pocket knife on her too.
Nah, he'd have took that from her.
Hey, okay, what's your knife of choice?
Any 3-inch blade, serrated on the bottom half, but you know, unserrated on the top. I like it to just go in easy. But anyway, I'm going to hit you so hard with it that it probably a break when I hit you with it. Because it don't really matter. I just 3 and 3, because in DC you can have a blade as long as it's 3 inches. So I just pick any 3-inch blade, man.
And more than likely, Ock, if you hit somebody full strength with it, yeah, they would probably initially think you just punched them. They wouldn't even know because it would be so quick and hard of a jab. Yeah. And that they wouldn't even know they were stabbed until moments after.
Right. Yeah. No, but I'm not coming at you like Bruce Lee in no fucking movie. I know how to like hit you with that shit, like hit you with it like a real life, hit you with it, like hit, tear away.
Well handled.
Yeah, I'm not like trying to like play fucking swordsmith with you and shit. I'm trying
John Wick.
I'm trying to rip your tendons and shit. You know what I'm saying? And shit like that. So it's like, it's not like a movie and shit. If I hit you with that shit, you won't feel like Wolverine is you fighting with Wolverine or some shit.
take that little 3-inch
twist and rip,
put it up underneath the armpit, man.
Yeah, whatever it hits, just twist and rip. Yeah, and pull and come back again. But definitely, definitely a woman though. Like if like the way I am, just if a woman was to come at me with a knife, if I'm on predator, if I'm out here predating and shit, and then the woman pulls out a knife, that's a close up weapon. She has to.
You got a longer reach, and you can pop her right in the head, and boom, she's done before you get in there.
You gotta train yourself to use that thing too, man. You don't really, you know. I carry five knives on me at all times, and you know when a situation comes, like I do not think about my knives at all.
Right. It's you gotta. A woman is not going to fucking be able to take all a fucking guy like that. Now maybe Steve from accounting, who's just, you know what I mean, like pushing up on you at the fucking at work party and shit. Yeah, you could probably fucking pull a knife on him and scare him. But this guy, these guys in Memphis, you pull that knife, he's gonna start laughing. You need something that you can hit him with from a distance, and if not a gun, mace.
Make sure you have some kind of self-defense tool with you. So, you know, pepper spray is a good one for distance.
In the case of an attempted kidnap, she says the best chance of surviving is to do all you can to avoid leaving the spot you're in. But if you find yourself in that situation, preparation is key.
Always carry something that is hidden. So even if you can't get away and you end up at that secondary location, you have a hidden weapon on you.
Thurman says the stun gun is helpful.
The sound itself is a deterrent. So when you hit that, you go, stay back, leave me alone.
But it's also a weapon.
And then if you have to, if they continue to come, that's when you touch them with this.
I still don't like the stun. I like the mace better because, I mean, we see some men get hit with tasers all the time. It doesn't affect them. I don't know. This is last resort, but I like the mace.
By the time you're using the tape, but this little taser in your hand, you already choked out.
Exactly. Yeah. Or punch. Like, you got to understand, like, some men hit hard, man. Like, I don't know where y'all are from, but, like, a woman, man, the dudes I used to fight when I was getting fights, man, a woman can't take those punches, man.
And I know that girl on that subway, dude.
And if you're a son woman, the son man gonna hit you extra hard.
Because he know you.
Yeah, he know we could take the first couple of punches. He gotta knock us out real good. Give him one good one.
That chick that was in that subway, man, she was probably intimidated and her adrenaline pumped up, so that's why she was able to take that.
What are you talking
was that
about?
Her man next door that didn't do shit?
Oh, yeah.
What a jackass, man.
Yeah. Oh well. Yeah. That white girl. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, that's something. But he didn't lean in on her. He didn't give her
not
yeah,
a full punch.
He punched the shit out of her and her boyfriend. Like, I feel sorry for him, man. Because I don't know how you come back from that, man. I would have
to feel sorry for him. Oh, he's a bitch.
He must have like a very weak psyche.
Yeah, but no, or he just like, look, man. It's fucking a crowded train with probably like fucking 100 people in a subway car and a grown ass man with his kids in tow.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Is fucking yelling at your fucking girlfriend. And then he slugs her. I think that's why Glock ladders think too much. So he's probably like, doesn't compute. Error. Nah, this is normal Sunday shit. Funny. I'm sitting here fucking arguing with your girl with my kids. And now I'm going to pop her in her jaw. And you got to fucking be able to like not go error. You got to be able to process that shit and react.
Yeah.
That shit really happened. I really just did that.
Most gliders too are taught to walk away and not to be confrontational and all that stuff, you know.
They're like, oh, I'll pray for you.
Yeah, that type of thing. You know, you gotta get those gliders that are taught to stick
like,
up for
don't
them
you
stuff.
Wanna be compassionate? Kind of mentality.
Yeah, I really just did that. It's sometimes it's hard to, like some man behavior a lot of times is so fucking wild. that it is hard for someone who probably has a rational mind to, you know, really compute what's really going on, man. But yeah, so Mary M says, ah, if you listen back to this show, you will hate the mic popping is constant.
I haven't heard that in a while, ever since the first complaint.
Oh, wow. Well, we'll see, man. I guess I haven't heard the name either.
There is a pop, like a snap going on every, you know, 60 seconds or so.
Oh, that noise. Yeah, man.
The people in the chat said it was you, Ock.
It's me? My mic is popping? Do I got to go to Best Buy and get a new mic? Is it me?
I mean, I'm not hearing it right now, but it was going off. Like,
why would y'all tell me 2 hours into the show? Like,
hey, you're the one that regulates the background sound, man.
But I can't hear.
It was more. It was more so the videos, like with the news, whatever. That's what it was doing it. But no, I haven't heard it. I haven't heard it at a consistent basis.
Yeah, I need y'all to tell me that because I can't. Hear that.
We got you, bro.
I can't hear it. I wouldn't know any of that was going on because I'm only getting the feed from StreamYard. I'm not getting the YouTube.
Well, if you're near Houston, man, I can drive you over a headset.
Oh no, I'm not near Houston, man. I'm just gonna go to Best Buy, man. let's
he's sitting in a place in DC right now.
Yeah, you're giving away my location, man.
Be careful and be mindful of your surroundings.
Yeah. So hold on. One if it's popping, two if it's not. Because I want to find out what's going on. And I gotta look at this poll, man, see what this poll is at for Rumble, man.
Damn, let's get ready to rumble.
It's 50-50, man. So yeah, after this, we'll go over to Rumble. It's 50-50. Wow, that's crazy, man. It's a deadlock.
For those that don't know, when we go over to Rumble, you know, we don't have to be censored. We get a little raw.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. Let me see if I can I'm gonna give you like to 12:10 to go over to Rumble because I'm about to end the stream on YouTube. So everybody, by 12:10, I'm gonna end the YouTube stream and we're only gonna be airing on Rumble.
Do they do super chats with Rumble and other stuff?
Yeah, they have super chat and all that stuff.
You have to set it up in there. You have, you know, set up your card or whatever in there, but you can do it.
Yeah. You have to set up an account over on Rumble if you want to comment, and you have to set up your account
payment.
If you want, payment account if you want a super chat. I'm gonna give everybody 10 minutes. Four more minutes before we go over there. What's up, mailman? What's going on, man?
It serves her right. White female billionaire, you know she was a BLM supporter, so she just got her money's worth.
Yeah, I mean, listen, man.
If you're gonna run out there, you know, have a security guard come in a car behind you watching you.
Well,
you got the money for it.
She voted for this. She asked for this. She supports criminal reform. I guarantee it.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure she does.
No.
And
no
she's
sympathy.
A teacher too.
No sympathy. None.
Damn. No sympathy.
She wanted to be compassionate.
She's a mother though. She got like 2 children.
Yeah.
That's her fault. That's her fault. Blame that on her.
Wow.
That ain't my fault. That ain't my concern either.
So Mayo, what's the likelihood that she's still breathing?
Oh, dude, she's in a dumpster somewhere, man.
Yeah.
They got him and they ain't got her. That bitch raped in a dumpster somewhere.
That's funny that you said the dumpster, man. We just saw them hauling away a dumpster.
Ding, 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 ding.
Unless he just, you know, beat her up, stabbed her a couple times, and she didn't die.
But how do you dispose of a body, man?
She dead, dude. Just leave that shit laying out in any general woods. Nobody's going to find that shit till hunting season.
Yeah, I think a jogger's going to find her. Because I don't think the sun man going to take her that deep. I think he dropped her ass off somewhere.
Now, the search for Fletcher has been exhaustive, involving multiple law enforcement agencies fanning out across the city, as you can see. This map gives you a quick look at just some of the locations where there has been a large law enforcement presence over the weekend. But detectives
give
have
me
not-
5 minutes in a room with the guy. I'll get him to give up the location. Either that or he loses his fucking manhood. That's, you know, that'll be what he gets.
Yeah, but they there's under no circumstances can they do that.
Are in relation to the mother's disappearance. You can see they stretch from Midtown out to East Memphis. And the searches today took investigators to several other parts of the city, including South Memphis. WRAG's Jordan James has been following law enforcement every step of the way. Jordan, what have you learned tonight?
Hey, Shay, Memphis police were spotted at apartment complexes, parks, and businesses all across the city in an effort to try to find Eliza Fletcher.
From the sky to the ground, a massive search is underway across Memphis for Eliza Fletcher.
More than anything, we want to see Eliza returned home safely.
It's been 3 days since the school teacher was last seen after jogging near the campus of the University of Memphis. Early Sunday morning, Memphis police announced the arrest of Cleotha Abston. Investigators say he waited for Fletcher to run by him and forced her into a vehicle and drove off. A police report revealed that DNA from a slide sandal left at the scene linked back to him. Despite being taken into custody, investigators say he did not provide information about Fletcher's whereabouts. Law enforcement.
So he's not telling. So they're going to have to find her.
She's growing maggots somewhere.
Dude, I hope her suffering is done, though. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I mean, listen, man, I think she was dead. She's been dead for about 3 days now. Some man ain't gonna play around like that, man. He just killed her, man, because he probably thought he could get away with it if he killed her. I mean, he was trying to clean his Jeep out. I mean, his truck out. He was trying to wash his clothes. He was trying to get away with it. He wasn't thinking like, oh, I'm done, fuck. He was actively trying to, you know,
like predatory kind of.
He was giving the sun woman at the apartment complex the creeps.
Yep, and you know you got to be real creepy for that.
Yeah, you got to be real creepy to spook a sun woman out.
They have the same evidence they have for every crime we've seen in New York City that they tracked this guy down with. What does the response have to do with the amount of money her family has?
Yeah, I mean,
they don't do this for everybody.
Here's the thing though. They do this for everybody. The only problem is that some women go missing so much and they get killed so much. This glider woman, if we go to the Memphis Gun Memorial. Even though this probably isn't a gun-related homicide, you probably couldn't find probably 5 glider women in the last year. Like, it's just uncommon for this to happen to them. So, yeah, it seems like there's a big response, but really, some women are killed all the time, and there's this type of response. It's just not a
natural. No, I'm not saying between some women. I'm saying between anybody in New York City.
Yeah.
They have the same evidence. They have a police department 20 times the size.
Yeah.
A lot higher tech. This has to do with the amount of money her family has, this response.
Well, I don't know.
MLK Park is on the river, so.
Oh, so that would be amazing if he dumped her body at MLK Park.
That would be
Park.
Some shit, man.
Oh, yeah. She's fish food. She's feeding worms or fish, one or the other.
Yep.
The content of her character, man. She got judged by the content of her character, man. Ain't that some shit, man?
Fletcher's whereabouts. Law enforcement spent majority of Sunday in South Memphis. Police telling WREG that they got a tip to check out Pine Hill Park, prompting dozens of officers to fill the area. They would not say what that tip was.
Well, I hope they just catch due process of the law.
Like many Memphians, Terrence.
Due process of the law.
van found himself keeping up with Fletcher's disappearance and is remaining optimistic as he spends the evening surrounded with friends, feet away from where officers are searching.
I hope that they find her alive because she got people that love her, you know. And if it's going any other way, you know, I just hope God can be able to comfort them.
A mile away from Pine Hill Park, officers were seen removing a dumpster from Longview Garden Apartments, which is where a relative of Abston lives. Officers later returned to the complex to conduct a manhunt, but did not provide specific details about who they were looking for. Despite law enforcement stopping at several other locations across the city, Fletcher has yet to be found.
We believe someone knows what happened and can help. If you have any information on this crime or Eliza's location, call the police.
All right, let me go over. I'm ending the YouTube stream now, so we're gonna go over to go over to Rumble.